SpaceX's goal has long been to achieve truly reusable rocket launch capabilities, and for good reason. The company anticipates huge cost savings through reusable rocketry versus expendable launch vehicles, which SpaceX CEO Elon Musk has described as a process akin to an airline throwing away their passenger aircraft every time they complete a flight. They've made lots of progress toward that goal and now frequently refly parts of their Falcon 9 rockets and their Dragon cargo capsules. But the Starship spaceship they're building now should be even more reusable. Each flight of this SpaceX's big Mars-colonizing spacecraft will have a very small price tag, if all goes according to plan. SpaceX's Starship could sport a low cost per rocket flight, somewhere in the region of $2 million. Musk provided an idea of just how much that could save SpaceX, and by extension its customers, at a surprise guest appearance at the U.S. Air Force's annual pitch day in LA this week. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss Elon Musk's SpaceX company, which is chasing the holy grail of completely reusing a rocket. Why Elon Musk thinks SpaceX launches will cost 1% of current NASA launches. Can Musk's latest claim possibly be true? Let's get into details. The Starship system, which consists of a reusable 100-passenger spaceship stacked atop a huge reusable rocket known as Super Heavy, will use just $900,000 worth of propellant to get off Earth and into orbit, Elon Musk said on Tuesday, November 5th, during a fireside chat at the Los Angeles Air Force Base with Lieutenant General John Thompson, commander of the U.S. Air Force Space and Missile System Center. Toward the end of the 40-minute conversation, Thompson gave Musk the floor to say anything he wanted to the audience of investors, engineers, entrepreneurs, and military officials. The SpaceX founder and CEO took the opportunity to talk about something near and dear to his heart, the importance of fully and rapidly reusable orbital rockets. This is the technological advance that will slash the cost of spaceflight by orders of magnitude, allowing humanity to become a truly spacefaring species, Musk has repeatedly said over the years. It's absolutely profound to have a reusable rocket, Musk said during the conversation. This is the holy grail. If you consider operational costs, maybe it'll be like $2 million out of SpaceX's pocket each time. This is much less than even a tiny rocket, Musk added. So it's something that needs to be made. To put that figure into perspective, NASA on average spends $152 million per launch, meaning if Musk is to be believed, his launches will cost just 1.3% of NASA's costs. It's an impressively low price, particularly considering the cost per kilogram to normally fly cargo into space. SpaceX's ultimate goals are aimed at reducing the cost of rocket launches, making them more commonplace, and using that to fund its goals of building bases on the Moon, Mars, and beyond. While its low costs would likely help reach the first goal, its use of liquid oxygen and methane as fuel means astronauts could conceivably embark on those more ambitious missions and refuel at the planet. Employees have also expressed an interest in building a base on the Moon. The Starship's ability to refuel on Mars could also enable a planet-hopping network that enables humanity to branch out further. SpaceX has been working to make this vision a reality, and the company has made considerable progress. SpaceX now routinely lands and reflies the first stages of its workhorse Falcon 9 rocket. And it's doing the same with the heavy-lift Falcon Heavy, which has three launches under its belt. The company is now also starting to recover and refly payload fairings, the protective nose cones that surround satellites during launch. Starship and Super Heavy fit well into this grand vision. Both vehicles will be fully reusable, and each individual craft will fly many times before it's retired, Musk has said. As the Starship is designed to transport at least 100 metric tons to Earth orbit, Musk compared it to the Boeing 747, which has a similar payload capacity of over 100 tons, which costs $500,000 to lease for a flight from San Francisco to Sydney and back. Although the rocket's going into space, it would only cost around 4 times more in terms of operation. Musk attributed this discrepancy, especially considering the cost of previous space technology, to SpaceX's focus on creating reusable rockets. A giant reusable craft costs much less than a small expendable craft, Musk said. The $2 million operational costs are a far cry from the amount SpaceX charges for its current launches, using its semi-reusable series of Falcon vehicles. For some perspective, SpaceX currently sells Falcon 9 launches for $62 million to send up to 5.5 tons to geosynchronous transfer orbit. And this is less than $2,500 per pound to orbit, compared to the $10,000 NASA pays to put 1 pound of payload in orbit. Falcon Heavy launches for $90 million to send up 8 tons of geosynchronous transfer orbit. Both of these result in a price of $11.3 million per ton, and those prices are considerably lower than similar services offered by SpaceX's competitors. Note that these are the final prices offered to buyers rather than the operational costs. When asked SpaceX to reveal the profit margins on its Falcon launches, the company refused to answer. However, an April 2016 analysis by investment firm Jefferies International estimated the gross margin at around 40%. That would mean SpaceX pays around $6.8 million for each ton it moves into geostationary transfer orbit using a Falcon vehicle. A Starship, based on Musk's figures, would cost around $20,000 per ton. Musk didn't specify what sort of flight this would cover, though. In August 2019, he suggests the cost of sending 1 ton of cargo to Mars could be around $100,000 at the low end. That would mean his ambitions of building a city with 1 million tons of cargo would cost $100 billion, although suggested the figure could be as high as $10 trillion. Starship will eventually replace all of SpaceX's launch vehicles, the company hopes, a goal that it hopes to achieve because its operation should eventually be much more cost-effective than either Falcon 9 or Falcon Heavy once it's fully complete and flying. Those SpaceX Starship missions will be quite varied. Starship and Super Heavy are designed primarily to help humanity settle Mars, the Moon, and other deep space destinations. But SpaceX wants the duo to take over all the company's needs eventually. So if all goes according to plan, Starship will also even clean up space junk and ferry up to 1,000 passengers from one city to another around Earth on the same rocket within the next 10 years, Musk has said. Starship's first mission could be something a little more straightforward, sending up a telecommunications satellite in 2021. Being able to do all of this for $2 million a pop would be revolutionary. That would be the cost of each mission for SpaceX, to be clear. We don't yet know how much the company will charge customers for a Starship mission. The Starship's low cost and high capacity could transform the space industry. Rick Tumlinson, founder of venture capital firm Space Fund, told that the Starship could be considered a Mayflower-class vehicle due to its ability to send up to 100 people into space at once. It's an extremely ambitious target. Despite cost plummeting thanks to improving reusability, a launch of SpaceX's much smaller workhorse rocket, Falcon 9, currently costs more than 30 times Musk's quoted price of a Starship launch. Does that mean Musk pulled the $2 million figure out of thin air? Maybe. At the Air Force event, Musk admitted he does zero market research whatsoever. At the same time as SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas team is working around the clock to prepare Starship Mark 1 for several major tests, the company is building a second dedicated Starship launch complex at Pad 39A. At SpaceX's Boca Chica, Texas Starship facilities, the company's already made a huge amount of progress fabricating and outfitting a brand new launch mount that will soon support Starship Mark 1's first propellant loading, static fire, and flight tests. SpaceX has officially begun to install a large steel structure at Launch Complex 39A, a pad the company has leased from NASA since 2014. This massive structure of launch mount will one day support SpaceX's first East Coast Starship and Super Heavy static fire and test flights. Although Boca Chica's launch mount is quite large, Pad 39A, Florida's nascent launch mount, is going to be significantly bigger. The section that SpaceX began installing in the first days of November appears to be much taller than the mount in Texas, and it also looks more like a rectangular corner than anything resembling part of Boca Chica's hexagonal structure. Even if it takes more than a year to build Launch Complex 39A launch mount, SpaceX could still be ready to attempt Starship's first orbital launch well before the end of 2020. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.